Stop the clock. Take time out. Time to regroup before you lose a bout. Freeze a frame. Back it up. Focus before they wrap it up. Years are getting shorter. Lines on your face are getting longer. Feel like you're treading water, but the riptide's getting stronger. Don't panic, don't jump ship. Can't fight it. Like Tack says, at least it happens only once in your life. They're singing happy birthday. You just want to lay down and cry. Not just another birthday. It's 39DY. Can't you stay 29? Hell, you still feel like you're 22. Turn 39, 90. Bang, you're dead. What can you do? What can you do? What can you do?
The runway, make another pass. Try one more approach before you're out of gas.
Friends are getting fatter. Hairs on your head are getting thinner. Feel like a cleanup batter on a team that ain't a winner.
Don't freak out, don't strike out. Can't fight it like City Hall. At least you're not alone. Your friends are there too.
They're singing happy birthday. You just wish you could run away. Who cares about a birthday but 39DK? Hey! Can you be optimistic? You're no longer the ingenue. Turn 30, 1990, boom-ya passe. What can you do? What can you do? What can you do? Peter Pan and Tinkerbell, which way to never, never land? Emerald City's gone to hell since the wizards blew off his command. On the street you hear the voices, lost children, crocodiles. You're not into making choices, wicked witches. Poppy fields are men behind the curtain. Tiger lilies, ruby slippers. Clock is ticking, that's for certain. They're singing happy birthday. I just wish it was true. It feels much more like doomsday. Fuck 39D. Seems like I'm in for a twister. I don't see a rainbow. Do you
turn 30 in the 90s?
Into my hands now, the ball is past. I want the spoils, but not too fast. The world is calling, it's now or never. And why can't I stay up so forever?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Dill Pickle Movie Network. I'm Dylan Randazzo, and welcome to the second annual Pickle Awards. We've made it here another year. It says the 2021 Pickle Awards. That's because these are honoring the best films, or my favorite films, of 2021. While they are taking place in 2022, I figured just to keep it in the brain, just throughout history, to remember that these are the movies of 2021. I wanted to call it the 2021 Pickle Awards. Call it whatever you want. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you're tuning in live, thank you so much. I see you in the chat. Thank you so much for chatting along. If you chat along tonight, and just for viewing and watching the Pickle Awards, I am so, so excited. Just to not only celebrate these films, but celebrate this channel in a year's time, just how much it's grown. When I started this, it was just myself talking about movies, and then two other people I was podcasting with, Kelsey in my Marvel podcast, Crosby on our Great American Film Off podcast, which will eventually come back. He is busy and doing amazing things in his life, but it's been on a hiatus. But I'm so grateful for those two for being the two that really helped me kickstart this channel. And then a month in, we got two brand new shows after that, Picture This with Chad, where we go through every single year in Oscars history. And then, of course, Frame Wreck with Matt Chapmond, where we go through all the best of the worst movies of all time, the movies that are so bad they're good. Those two shows were really amazing. They are still amazing. They're still going on. You can check out some recent episodes up there in the top right. And then, of course, Zach, Recipe for Reality. A little later down the line, we started a show about television, because television is something I'm passionate about, especially reality television. So there are five shows on this channel that I have to give all my gratitude to. Those five people: Chad, Kelsey, Matt, Crosby, Zach. All five of them helped grow this channel to be what it is. And before I get to any awards, before I get to any presenters, which a lot of these people are presenting tonight, but before I get to any of that, I just wanted to thank them for helping this channel be what it is. It would not survive without them. I would not be as passionate as I am about this channel without them. It's really fun to sit in front of a camera and tell you how much I love the Batman, but it's even more fun talking about how much I love to hate Batman and Robin with Matt, or talking about The Dark Knight getting snubbed for Best Picture with Chad, or talking about Marvel, not just DC, with Kelsey, maybe doing some feuds with Crosby on Film Off, and of course, going to the televisions afterwards and talking about reality shows with Zach. So thank you guys so much. Zach and Kelsey were the two who helped me sing that opening number, which I'm also very grateful for. Hope you enjoy that opening number. Thank you so much for joining the Pickle Awards. Why don't we get to the awards? I think it's time. We're going to start with some of the superlatives, you know, start off a little strong with the best movie opening. There were some really, really great openings that opened films of 2021. A film is only as good, well, it's only as good as all its parts, but it really, it depends on a big opening to reel you in, to really make it a masterpiece from start to finish. So these are the nominees for best movie opening.
Leave them out of this. Your quarrel is with me.
I ain't gonna say it twice. Turn up the street lights. We taking the flight to a couple of days in the life for what it's like
in Washington Heights.
Those are the nominees. The winner for the Audience Award, Tick Tick Boom, 3090 is strong. It's still going strong. Wins the Audience Award. And the pickle goes to West Side Story. Congratulations. Those are your winners for the first ever Pickle Award of 2021. Congratulations. If you haven't heard 3090, you did earlier. If you're tuning in late and you haven't watched it, please go back and listen, because Zach and Kelsey were really amazing in helping me record that number. And go see that movie, because that opening's great. And go see West Side Story. Go see all those movies. Now let's get to the best movie closing. I know we're jumping all the way to the end, but we're going to start at the very beginning and now to the very end. The best movie closing, the nominees are...
Now, off with your head.
Go find out for me, will ya?
And the Audience Award goes to Spider-Man No Way Home. And the pickle goes to The Green Knight. Congratulations, you had my favorite ending finale of any film of 2021. So many good films, so many great endings. Now let's get to one of my other favorite superlatives. But to help me present two of these superlatives, I'm going to be presenting the award for Best Kiss. We all love a good movie kiss. And of course, the worst film of the year. And I figured who to present the worst film of the year but the guy who does a show with me about bad movies, Mr. Matt Chapmond. So Mr. Matt Chapmond is on the other line here to present the awards for Best Kiss and Best Worst Movie of 2021. Matt, take it away.
All right, I think I'm on. Am I on? Can you hear me? Okay. I'm coming to you now from a bunker deep underground. I can't tell you where it is, but I was looking into my disappearance, where I'd been for 6 months. If you've been following on Framework, you know that I'm missing some time. And I got close. I think I got too close. So right now, I'm in hiding. I don't know what's going to happen to me. I hope I live long enough to review Reefer Madness on the Dill Pickle Movie Network on 420. Check out the channel on April 20th to see that. If I do die, know that I die doing what I love, presenting a Pickle Award. The first award I'm going to present is Best Kiss, and it's fitting that I'm going to present this award because I have, in fact, kissed a person. More than one, mind you. A great kiss can be everything. It can change your life. When that kind of kiss is translated on screen, it can be magical. The nominees for Best Kiss are... And the audience award goes to Spider-Man No Way Home. And the Pickle Award goes to Spider-Man No Way Home. Congratulations, Spider-Man, Tom Holland, and Zendaya. Those two kids are just the cutest, aren't they? Now, the next thing... safe for now. I think I do have time to present one more award. And it's the award we've all been waiting for. It's the big one of the night. I presume this is the last one to be presented, as it is the most important. The worst film of the year. Now, everyone has different opinions, and we all can find something to love in some movies, and some movies just don't work for us. And if we all liked the same things, the world would be pretty boring. Sometimes we all agree, though. This movie stinks. Here's five that stink. And the nominees are Cinderella, He's All That, Music, Space Jam, A New Legacy, and Thunder Force. And the audience award goes to Space Jam, A New Legacy. That was a very, very bad movie. Well deserved. And the Pickle Award goes to Music. Now, I'm going to... Alright, I have to go.
Thank you so much, Matt. I know you seem to be in a different location than usual. I hope you're okay, but we're going to proceed with the awards. Matt, thank you so much for doing that. This was a really big year for musicals and comedies. I mean, musicals especially. You see some posters behind me. This was the year of the musical. We had so many good musicals, so many that didn't even get nominated for this category because there are so many. We will get to the best musical or comedy film in just a bit, but let's present first the award for best actor in a musical and or comedy film. The nominees are...
Of course he is.
Of course.
In a sense that... I interrupted. Please continue.
I've never actually spoken to him.
Of your love?
Of anything.
And reason so... So faint and shrill.
To take that on.
I stood above the deep abyss.
I have been rehearsing all day. I have been up since 4 this morning. I have been trying to write a song for a week, and I am nowhere.
How do you want to face it? Do you want to waste it when the end is so close you can taste it? Y'all could cry with your head in the sand. I'ma fly this flag that I got in my hand.
I don't want to be here, all right? This is embarrassing.
Well, I don't want you
here. You think I
want
to show up like this? I got my ass kicked. I just need a place to crash. Why can't you be home?
What, does it look like a hotel?
And the audience award goes to Andrew Garfield, Tick, Tick, Boom. And the pickle goes to Andrew Garfield, Tick, Tick, Boom. A really great performance. Congratulations, Andrew. And now the nominees for Best Actress in a Comedy and or Musical Film. The nominees are...
No, gracias. Yo no soy americana. Yo soy puertorriqueña.
I mean, I knew it. I knew that was what you were thinking. You're always thinking things, you thinker. You thinker. You think things.
So.
I just told you that I did. I told you that I reached
okay,
out.
Well, why don't you just call me like an adult?
Nobody calls, so.
Well, grow up.
The audience award goes to Rachel Zegler, West Side Story. Congratulations. And the pickle award goes to Ariana DeBose, West Side Story. Two amazing performances. Congratulations. And now the award for best comedy and or musical film. The nominees are In the Heights, Licorice Pizza, Shiva Baby, Tick, Tick, Boom, and West Side Story. And the audience award for best musical and or comedy is Tick, Tick, Boom. And the pickle award goes to West Side Story. Congratulations. Now, because we're talking about music, we're talking about musicals, we're talking about comedy, why don't we go over some of the music categories? And one of my best friends growing up, I met through doing music. He's one of my best friends in the whole entire world. He co-hosts the Recipe for Reality podcast and show here on the channel. It is Mr. Zach Love presenting the awards for Best Original Score and Best Original Song. Take it away, Zach.
Hey there, movie fans. You may know me as Zach Love, Dylan's assistant chef in the kitchen for Recipe for Reality. But today I'm happy to be here presenting the award for Best Original Score as well as Best Original Song from a movie. Our nominees for Best Original Song are
When We Chase That Sky Beyond the Shore.
Now you've never seen me cry. There's just more time to die.
So may we start.
The audience award winner is We Don't Talk About Bruno from Disney's Encanto. Our nominees for best score are Dune, The French Dispatch, The Green Knight, The Power of the Dog, and Spencer. And the pickle award, as well as the audience award, goes to Dune. Thank you guys so much for supporting such an amazing channel. Dylan, everything that you do on this channel is absolutely phenomenal. I'm honored to be able to be a co-host with you on such an amazing, amazing platform. And I'm looking forward to many more years of friendship and co-hosting ahead. Enjoy the rest of the Pickle Awards, everybody.
Thank you so, so much, Zach, for presenting those awards. Now, everyone loves a good musical, and some of these musicals translate really well to the animated form. So I think it's time to talk about the best animated films and performances of the year, starting with best voice actor in an animated film and or an animated character in a live-action film. You'll get the gist when you see these clips. These are not actors you can see their faces for, but you can definitely hear their voices, and they brought a lot of great work to their roles. The nominees for best actor in a voice role.
Silencio, Bruno. What's wrong with you, stupido?
Huh?
honey, I respect your ideas and value your opinions. And now you talk.
We're going to put this show on whether Crystal likes it or not. But first, we're going to jump out that window.
See that? It's pretending to read a book.
So smart, me. Enjoy books so much.
Madams, what's wrong with you, stupid old?
And the audience award goes to Sylvester Stallone for The Suicide Squad. And the pickle goes to Sylvester Stallone, Suicide Squad. There he is right there, the King Shark himself. Congratulations, Sylvester Stallone. And the nominees for Best Voice Actress are...
I will never be good enough for you. No matter how hard I try.
Why would anything be wrong? I'm totally fine. The magic's fine. Luisa's fine. I'm totally not nervous.
Abuela was happy. The family was happy. You want to be a better sister? Apologize for ruining my life.
You guys like Robo Slayers 4? No one around here has even heard of that.
Why not? It's amazing.
After all these years, I'm finally gonna meet my people.
My sword here says we're not. Yeah, I knew you couldn't handle rolling solo. You're nothing without your band.
And the audience award goes to Stephanie Beatriz and Kanto. And the pickle award goes to Abby Jacobson, The Mitchells vs. the Machines. Congratulations. And now the award for Best Animated Feature. The nominees are Belle, Encanto, Luca, The Mitchells vs. the Machines, and Sing 2. And the audience award goes to, voted on by you guys, in a very close vote, The Mitchells vs. the Machines. Congratulations. And the pickle award goes to Encanto. I know we're not supposed to talk about Bruno, but he just won Best Song, so I figured we could talk about Bruno now. Congratulations, Encanto, Mitchells vs. Machines, two really, really great films. All those films, really, really great. So now, let's get into some of the technical categories. Let's go into the design awards, the awards that bring the real flavor, the real spectacular spectacle to the screen. I don't know how to speak tonight. Anyway, here are the nominees for Best Visual Effects. The nominees are Dune, Godzilla vs. Kong, The Green Knight, The Matrix Resurrections, and No Time to Die. And the audience award goes to Dune. And the pickle award goes to Dune. Congratulations, Dune. You are a two-time pickle award winner for best score and now best visual effects. Let's see if it'll continue the trend. Here are the nominees for best sound. Dune, Last Night in Soho, No Time to Die, A Quiet Place Part 2, and West Side Story. And the audience award goes to Dune, and the pickle award goes to Dune. Congratulations. Now moving on to best film editing. It is so important to have good editing. This whole project, I know some of this stuff is live, but a lot of these presenters filmed videos, sent them in. It's really amazing how great they were in editing their videos. So let's honor some of these films that edited their films very, very well. The nominees for Best Film Editing are The Green Knight, Tick, Tick, Boom, Titane, The Voyeurs, and West Side Story. And the audience award goes to Tick, Tick, Boom. Congratulations. And the pickle award goes to The Green Knight. Congratulations, The Green Knight. Moving on now to the visual, the camera work, the lighting. It is best cinematography. And the nominees are The Green Knight, Nightmare Alley, The Power of the Dog, The Tragedy of Macbeth, and West Side Story. The audience award goes to West Side Story. And the pickle award goes to West Side Story. Congratulations. Cinematography, I'll have to be honest, was one of the hardest categories to choose a winner in. And now rounding out the technical awards, let's do Best Production Design. The nominees are Dune, The French Dispatch, Nightmare Alley, The Tragedy of Macbeth, and West Side Story. And the Audience Award for Best Production Design goes to Dune. And the Pickle Award for Best Production Design goes to The French Dispatch. Congratulations. We have a few more design awards later, costumes and hair and makeup. But before we get to that, speaking of costumes and makeup, she had her own makeup line. She has a great YouTube channel. Kelsey Kilpatrick, my co-host for Marvelous Movie Mondays, is here to present a few more awards, some superlatives, some other awards related to the action genre, because there are a lot of Marvel films that came out last year. So presenting the awards for Best On-Screen Couple, Best Villain, and Best Actor, Actress, and Action Picture. Here is Kelsey Kilpatrick.
Hello, everyone. It's me, Kelsey, the co-host of Marvelous Movie Mondays, the podcast you can find right here at the Dill Pickle Movie Network. And I'm here to present the awards for the action category, because apparently superhero-based content is all I'm good for. Dill. I'm just kidding. Let's get into it. The nominees for Best Action Sequence are... And the audience award goes to the bus fight from Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings. And the pickle award goes to the bus fight from Nobody. Little bit of a plot twist there, keeping you on your toes. And the nominees for Best Actor in an Action Film are...
We only had more time.
You have all the time in the world.
You're a real father of the year.
Fine, you know what? Tyler needs to grow up anyway. She's a little ditzy like a f***ing mother. So a year in juvie, no f***ing problem.
It still fits.
Oh my God.
May. What are you doing? May, please, will you just wake up and talk to me, please?
This doesn't make us even, because after all, you came to my house, which you know you don't f***ing do.
And the audience award goes to Tom Holland, Spider-Man No Way Home. And the pickle award goes to Tom Holland, Spider-Man No Way Home. And the nominees for Best Actress in an Action Film are...
You're nothing. You have nothing.
There are 50 people on this planet.
Oh, stop it!
Don't tell me to stop!
I don't tell you when to stop, then how will you know when to shut up?
What is that?
That is an overhead projector.
Do you ever use it anymore?
No, not really.
So why don't you just throw it away?
It was real to me. You are my mother. The best part of my life was fake. And none of you told me.
All of you.
I love you.
Just wait. Wait, you tell me when you see me again.
And the audience award goes to Florence Pugh, Black Widow. And the pickle award goes to Florence Pugh in Black Widow. Great minds think alike. And the nominees for Best Action Film are Eternals, No Time to Die, Spider-Man No Way Home, Suicide Squad, and Zack Snyder's Justice League. And the audience award goes to Spider-Man No Way Home. I feel like we all saw that coming. And to no surprise, the Pickle Award also goes to Spider-Man No Way Home. Congratulations to that cast and crew. It is now time to present the award for Best Villain, the characters we love to hate and hate to love. The nominees are...
That's some neat trick. That sense of yours.
Norman?
Norman's on sabbatical, honey.
Know this. Redwood would never be yours. Never. 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 Matter of fact, you ain't welcome here no more.
Mr. Anderson!
I've missed you.
You love her, huh?
我不知道，我真的不知道。
No.
I don't lose. I won't lose. I'm never letting you go.
And the audience award goes to William Dafoe, Spider-Man No Way Home. And the Pickle Award goes to William Dafoe, Spider-Man No Way Home. Now it's time for me to present the award for Best On-Screen Couple. The people we love to watch so we can live vicariously through them. I'm looking at you, Zendaya. And the nominees are David Alvarez and Ariana DeBose, West Side Story. Melissa Barea and Anthony Ramos, In the Heights. Ansel Elgort and Rachel Zegler, West Side Story. Leslie Grace and Corey Hawkins, In the Heights. And Tom Holland and Zendaya, Spider-Man No Way Home. And the audience award goes to Tom Holland and Zendaya, Spider-Man No Way Home. And the Pickle Award goes to Melissa Barea and Anthony Ramos, In the Heights.
Thank you so much, Kelsey, and congratulations to all the winners in those categories. Now we're going to keep going with some of the design awards, starting with the Best Costume Design Award. The nominees are Cruella, Cyrano, Dune, Spencer, and West Side Story. And the audience award goes to Cruella. And the Pickle Award goes to Cruella. Congratulations, Cruella. And the nominees for Best Hair and Makeup Design. A lot of cool nominees here. The nominees are Candyman, Coming to America, Dune, The Green Knight, and The Suicide Squad. Ooh. And the audience award. Gotta start with you guys first. Audience first. Audience always comes first. You guys rock. Thank you so much for voting, by the way. The audience award goes to The Suicide Squad. Congratulations. And the Pickle Award goes to Candyman. Congratulations. And now let's move on to some of the foundational elements to making any film, and that is the Screenplay Awards. Here are the nominees for Best Adapted Screenplay. Drive My Car, Dune, The Power of the Dog, Tick, Tick, Boom, and West Side Story. And the Audience Award for Best Adapted Screenplay goes to Tick, Tick, Boom. Congratulations. And the Pickle Award for Best Adapted Screenplay goes to Drive My Car. Congratulations. Now moving on to the Best Original Screenplay nominations. The nominees are Come On, Come On, Pig, Red Rocket, Titane, and The Worst Person in the World. And the nominee, sorry, I just read the nominees, and the winner for Best Original Screenplay from the audience. The audience award goes to Pig, and the Pickle Award goes to The Worst Person in the World. Congratulations. Those are your screenplay winners. Now I think it's time to check in with one more guest who wanted to present an award. He is a common face you see on the channel. He competed in some Marvel trivia alongside the greats like JD, Corey, and Stacy. But he also has a show with me on this channel. Picture this. He is the king of horror, I like to call him, Mr. Chad Webb. We're going to throw it over to Chad. Chad, are you there?
Chad, what are you doing?
Oh, me? Murder.
Aren't you supposed to be doing something for Dylan right now?
Oh, crap! That's right. Oh, shoot. Oh, shoot. Oh, crap. Yes. Okay. And the nominees for Best Actor in a Sci-Fi / Horror Film are...
If you say his name 5 times while looking in the mirror, he appears in the reflection and kills you.
Yahya Abdul-Mateen II in Candyman.
If I can see it. If you'll have us, we will come.
Timothy Chalamet in
Dune.
Ça va faire quoi avec cette ruche? Je fais pas du tricot là. Je vais me battre. Allez. Vas-y, maintenant pour de vrai. Maintenant pour de vrai!
Vincent Linden in Titane.
The people that are left, what they've become. You don't know, do you? Well, I do. They're not the kind of people worth saving.
Cillian Murphy in A Quiet Place Part 2.
Still open. This can't be real.
Keanu Reeves in The Matrix Resurrections. Ah. The Audience Award goes to Vincent Linden in Titane. The Pickle Award goes to Vincent Linden in Titane. Congrats.
The nominees for the best actress in a sci-fi slash horror film are...
Owen. I can't hear you.
Rebecca Hall in The Night House.
Look at me.
Thomasin McKenzie in Last Night in Soho.
I have a few rules. Don't take smokers. No male visitors after 8 o'clock.
That's a problem.
And no using the laundry room at night.
Diana Rigg, Last Night in Soho.
Ça va pas?
Non, je suis crevée.
Je te prête mon lit.
Agathe Roussel in Titane.
So what do you do, Sandy?
Well, I sing, of course.
As you dancing.
Anya Taylor-Joy in Last Night in Soho.
Care for a demonstration?
Great list. And the Audience Award goes to Rebecca Hall in The Night House. And the Pickle Award goes to Agathe Roussel in Titane. Congrats.
And the nominees for best sci-fi slash horror film are...
Last Night in Soho. The Matrix Resurrections. And the Audience Award goes to... And the Pickle Award goes to... Titane. Congrats. There are so many great horror films that came out last year. There's so many good ones that are coming out this year. I'm very, very excited for the future of horror and film. Please go check out and support a lot of your great horror filmmakers, you know, especially the indie ones, because, you know, they need it and we want to get more and more great horror films. You know, thank you for all your support. This has been amazing.
Thank you so much, Chad, for presenting those awards. And thank you for the little disclaimer at the end. I'm very glad. Thank you so much, though, for presenting. And thank you all for still tuning in. Now we're getting to the cream of the crop, the creme de la creme. These are the big awards, starting with some of the acting awards. We are going to present first the award for Best Acting Ensemble. And the nominees are The Harder They Fall, In the Heights, Licorice Pizza, Mass, and West Side Story. And the Audience Award goes to In the Heights. And the Pickle Award goes to West Side Story. Congratulations. And now the award for the best young actor or actress. Now, this doesn't mean a little kid necessarily, even though there are some nominated, but this could also be anyone under the age of like 21, around the age of 18, a young up and coming actor who either made their first appearance in a film or was a breakout star despite being so young, just and really impressing me with their work. There were some really, really talented young actors out there working this year. So I really, really happy that this category exists to acknowledge some of the best. The nominees for Best Young Actor or Actress are...
I said m'lady. I said m'lady. What my lady. I don't need you to tell me whether I'm cool or not.
As every fairy tale comes real, I've looked at love that way.
The question is, why do you want to do it?
You are just terrible at this.
Oh, man, I'm trying.
Venus Williams.
What you want?
Let's show all those people that I can handle what's coming.
It all began tonight. I saw you on the world went away.
And the audience award goes to Amelia Jones, Coda. And the Pickle Award goes to Rachel Zegler, West Side Story. Congratulations. Those are some great performances. Now, before we get into the rest of the performances, we still got some big categories left. We got supporting actor, supporting actress, actor and actress, director, and of course, best picture. Everyone wants to know what the best picture is. And of course, the announcement at the end of the show of what the new show on the Dill Pickle New Movie Network is going to be. It's very exciting. But before we did that, I did want to pay some respects to some people that we lost in 2021 and, of course, in the first few months of 2022. It has been a very tough year, just coming off of the rest of COVID and just, you know, a lot of people you grow up loving just get old, and it's very sad. And we did lose some very, very talented names, but their memories always live on, and we were very, very humbled and appreciative to be in the presence of such great work on screen, off screen, behind the camera, in front of the camera, et cetera, et cetera. But this is an homage to them. So please, everyone, take this moment and help me in honoring some of the great heroes of the silver screen, of the big screen, the small screen, all screen. Everyone, this is the In Memoriam.
There's a place for us, somewhere a place for us, peace and quiet and open air, wait for us somewhere. There's a time for us, someday a time for us, time together with time to spare, time to learn, time to care, someday, somewhere, we'll find a new way of living, we'll find a way of forgiving, somewhere. There's a place for us, somewhere a place for us. Hold my hand and we're halfway there. Hold
All right, and we are back for the final few categories. I'm so excited to get to these. Let us start here with Best Supporting Actor. These are actors that really helped just round out the entire projects that they were in. Even if they were smaller roles in some of the leads, they really brought a huge impact to their films. Here are the nominees for Best Supporting Actor.
You know, I wake up to everything I know either getting sold or wrecked or being taken over by people that I don't like. And they don't like me. And you know what's left out of all that? The Jets.
I need everybody to repeat after me. I am a revolutionary.
You're all that I need to get by.
Pas juste dire oui comme tout le monde. Tout le monde sait dire oui, même un Piaf, il sait dire oui. Même mon téléphone, il sait dire oui, c'est rien. Dis oui.
Oui.
Voilà, payez 20 balles, ce truc de merde.
Be funny, comma, when you can, period.
What's that?
My dad used to say that to me.
Really?
Yeah.
And the audience award goes to Daniel Kaluuya, Judas and the Black Messiah. And the pickle goes to Daniel Kaluuya, Judas, and the Black Messiah. Congratulations, Daniel, and to all those nominees on giving phenomenal performances. Now, for Best Supporting Actress in a Motion Picture, equally as impressive, really brought such live beauty to this, to all the films they were in their acting work, sometimes in their song work, in their spoken word, in their Shakespearean dialogue, all types of dialogue, all types of performances, such great range. Here are the nominees for Best Supporting Actress.
Hey, Javi! Ponle fuego! ¡Vamos!
I wonder why it was stars she gave us. Why not diamonds? Why not hearts? Why not spades?
Shall neither night nor day hang upon his penthouse lid. He shall live a man forbid.
Goodness, John. After all these years, what would it matter if you found out that I was 1 or 2% colored, hmm?
Well, you can turn.
Send your coins, send your battlements, and try as you might, all you hold dear will succumb to it. Your skin. Your bones. Your virtue.
And the audience award goes to Ariana DeBose, West Side Story. And the Pickle Award goes to Ariana DeBose, West Side Story, congratulations. And now moving on to the next and last acting awards, starting with Best Actor. The nominees are
Derek, why do you care about these people? They don't care about you. None of them. They don't even know you. Because you haven't shown them.
You didn't play? Sure did practice a terrible lot. See, you wouldn't think there's much difference between a cinema pit and a dinner party.
I'm gonna spend my time this way.
This is f- up, and that makes sense.
This is f- up, and that makes sense.
How could this be so f- up make sense?
It's-
Tomorrow and tomorrow creeps in this petty pace from day to day to the last syllable of recorded time.
And the audience award goes to Andrew Garfield, Tick Tick Boom. And the pickle goes to Andrew Garfield, Tick Tick Boom. Congratulations, Andrew, on yet another Pickle Award win. And the nominees for Best Actress are
my fate and our child's fate will be written not by God's will, but by which old man will tire first.
Hvor mange klesskap skal du ha?
Hvor mye kan jeg få?
Det... Nei, det ikke sånn det funker.
If I stop being really silly the next few days. Just tell me. I'll only believe it if it's you who tells me.
Tonight, tonight, the world is full of light.
And the audience award goes to Kristen Stewart Spencer. And the Pickle Award goes to Rachel Zegler, West Side Story. Thank you guys so much for voting for all those categories. We got two categories left. I can't believe it. But as I promised, we are going to announce a brand new show on the channel. And I think this is about the time to do it, right? So without further ado, here is the announcement of the new show. That is right. Draft Day. It's a name of a film that my dad really, really loves. It's a name of a day that happens across a lot of sports where they draft new players. And for here on the Dill Pickle Movie Network, what Draft Day is, I will sit down with several other members of the Dill Pickle Movie Network staff. You never know which staff members are going to show up. Maybe it'll be Chad, Matt, Kelsey, maybe even Crosby, Zach, who knows? They will be here joined with me and maybe some other special guests. And we will have our own little draft depending on the topic. So you could end up seeing a musicals category, for instance. And the parameters are that each one of us has to draft a Golden Age musical, a modern musical, an original musical, a musical based on Broadway, and maybe even a filmed musical that has been put on Disney Plus, like Hamilton. I don't know. But what we will do is we will go through the draft, picking our picks in a snake-like fashion. Not snake-like in our behavior, but just in the way the draft works. But we'll be drafting things, and then it will go on to a poll where you all at home can vote on Twitter for the winner of the draft. Every given month. This is going to air once a month on this channel. If we love it so much, if we have the availability, if we have the time, we might even show it twice a month. But right now we're going to start once a month, starting in April with the first draft, which is going to be a Disney draft. That's right. We will be drafting things like the best princess, the best villain, the best Disney song, the best Disney film, maybe the best Disney era. Either way, it's going to be really fun seeing what some of my panelists and guests bring to the table, because I really want this, like I've said from the very beginning, to be a network. I don't want it to be about me. I want it to be about the other people that inspire me, that I love to hear from. And this show is a way to bring on other people, to collaborate, to draft some really, really cool choices, maybe some unconventional choices, but it's going to be really fun. I hope it's a fun show. I hope people enjoy watching. So Draft Day will be coming in April. If that name is taken, if it's copyrighted, I don't know. I haven't really looked into it, but we will name it something else if that's the case. But Draft Day is a tentative name, subject to change. But Draft Day on the Dill Pickle Movie Network is very much a go, and it's very much a thing, starting with the Disney draft in April. So thank you all so much for tuning in, as I said, as we get to these last two categories. And I'll tell you right now, you guys voted so many great options through tonight. But these last two categories got very close in their winners. So I will just tell you that going into these categories, that the audience award voting was very close, so much so that I have some more news to share about Best Picture, because it was a crazy category. So many films neck and neck. But first, let's get to Best Director. The nominees are Julia DeCorno, Titane, David Lowery, The Green Knight, Steven Spielberg, West Side Story, Joaquin Trier, The Worst Person in the World, and Denis Villeneuve, Dune. And the audience award goes to Denis Villeneuve, Dune. And the Pickle Award goes to Julia DeCorno, Titane. Congratulations. And now, the award that you've all been waiting for. The award for Best Picture. The nominees are
go.
May his passage cleanse the world and keep the world for his people.
Nor is this his son.
We in the Black Panther Party don't believe in no culture except revolutionary culture. What we mean by that is a culture that will free you.
Yeah.
I'll be honest right now. These categories were close, but no category across the board was as close as Best Picture. So much so that there were two films tied for Best Picture by the deadline. And we got over 400 votes. So that means these two films, there were such great fan bases repping two films. And I will tell you what these two films were in just a sec. These two films were tied. So I put out another poll. I said, rank all of them. Rank all the nominees. And once again, the poll was so close that it came down to two votes to decide the winner. Now, I did not vote in the audience poll. My pick, I will tell you my pick for the Pickle Award in just a sec, but I want to shout out these two films. Coda and Dune were the two films that were tied, went into the next round. So I wanted to shout both of them out. On the first poll, they were tied for the audience award, but in that revote, there was one film that slightly edged out the other. So, according to y'all, the audience award for Best Picture between two deserving films, between 10 deserving films, the winner is Dune. Congratulations. And the Pickle Award, not as close because it's only one person voting, but my award for the Best Picture of the year. And I actually have a special little thing for this. I have my own electronic yodeling pickle right here. I don't want to open it because it's precious, and I don't want to ruin the beautiful box of the yodeling pickle. But the Pickle Award for Best Picture goes to Titane. Congratulations. We gotta love French cinema. We love all cinema here at the Dill Pickle Movie Network, and I'm very honored to award that as my favorite film of this year. There were so many amazing films. All 10 of those films equally deserving for Best Picture, but Dune is your audience winner. Titane is your Pickle Award winner. A lot of amazing winners across the board. I just want to give one last amazing shout out to Chad, Kelsey, Matt, and Zach for helping me present, as well as Crosby, who did not present tonight, but is still a member of this channel, helped me make this channel what it is. And we will be back with Film Off someday, I promise you. I also want to shout out some of my trivia competitors, Corey, Stacy, JD, of course, Chad also, and then Kelsey and Zach. I mean, so many great people competing on Marvelous Movie Mondays. I also want to thank Elizabeth Valenti, who was on my channel a few months ago to rank players on Big Brother this past summer. I love having guests on this channel, and it's really, really humbling to see so many people respond so happily when I ask them to be on the channel and vice versa. I just really, really love making this a network. I don't want this to be the Dill and Randazzo channel. I want this to be the Dill Pickle Movie Network. This is about bringing people together to talk about things we love, movies, TV shows, anything, music, books. Tell me about them. I'd love to hear about them in the comments. To everyone who watched tonight, the Pickle Awards, thank you so much. To everyone who sat through some singing, thank you for humbling me there as well. Thank you guys so much for watching these movies and voting for these movies. Like I said, we had over 400 votes in the polls, and I know 400 is not a big number, but to me, that is a huge number. I thought we'd only get like 25, 30 votes, but the fact that we got 400 people voting on the Pickle Awards, and you guys chose some amazing winners, so much so that we had to run another poll because Coda and Dune tied. I mean, we had a tie for Best Picture at the Pickle Awards. That is awesome, audience, and I'm so grateful that you guys are here on the journey with me. Hopefully, we'll be back for another Pickle Awards, assuming more than 10 movies that I love came out this year. I can already tell you, there have been at least 10 movies that I really like that came out, so there will be another live YouTube, I trip over my words. Next year, there will be another ceremony. Thank you guys so much for watching this one. And again, stay tuned for all those shows on the channel, as well as Draft Day, the newest show on the Dill Pickle Movie Network. It was really fun to tease it this week on Twitter and finally announce it to you right now on the Pickle Awards. And thank you once again to everyone tuning in all around the world. Thank you to my parents. I love you. My siblings, my best friends. Yeah, you guys rock. Thank you guys so much for doing this. And have a very safe and healthy rest of your year. Next week are the Oscars. So we'll be talking more about the Oscars next week as well. I will be giving you my predictions for those so you can follow along. And then, of course, we will have an episode of Picture This where we talk about the nominees in depth. So if you want to hear me talk about things like West Side Story, Coda, if you want to hear me talk about movies that were nominated tonight, like Belfast, you know, stay tuned for that show because it's going to be a lot of fun ranking those with Chad as well. I think that's all I have for you all today. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. It really means everything, literally everything to me from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much. Stay cool. I'll see you next year. Maybe someday you'll be a Pickle Award winner. Who was your favorite winner of the night? Are there any snubs, surprises? Let me know in the comments. Like, subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.